The recording has started. So good morning, students. This is a class of geotechnical engineering. So you can take this class as a revision class. So we're going to go back to the module one, and we'll try to solve some numerical based on index properties of soil. Okay. So I have collected few numerical that already came in GATE examination, previous GATE examination. Okay, so related to index properties of soil. Fine. So let me first share my screen, then I'll discuss. So my screen is visible, right? Can you see this? Is it visible? Do respond. Okay. What happens to other? So anyway, here you can see this is a numerical that came in GATE examination in the year 2002. Okay, so here it is. So what is the numerical says? And this particular numerical is related to that concept of relative density. Okay, or density index. So these all are same. So what is relative density or density index? So these things already discussed in the first module. So density index or relative density can be defined as a ratio of difference between void ratio, difference of void ratio in loose state and a natural void ratio to the void ratio in loose state and minus void ratio in dense state. Okay, E max minus E, E max minus E minimum. Okay, so E max is defined as what? It is a void ratio for a loose soil or particular soil which is in loose state. Okay, and what is E minimum? E minimum is the void ratio of a soil which is in a densest state. Okay. So what is the problem? It's saying that void ratio at the densest, loosest, and the natural state of a sand deposit are 0.2, 0.6, and 0.4 respectively. So that means for a particular soil, void ratio values of void ratios are given for different state, dense state, loose state, and natural in situ state. Okay, or you can say the filled state. For this, with this information, you need to find out the relative density of the soil, and here is the options are given. Okay, so it's a very simple question that came in 2002 GATE examination. So here E minimum is given as what? E minimum. So the void ratio at the densest state is given as 0.2. Void ratio at densest state means E minimum. So E minimum is given as 0.2. Void ratio at loose state is given as 0.6. So loose state means E maximum. So E max is given as 0.6, and the natural state, that means a general E is given as 0.4. So 0.4. So it's very simple now. If you get this formula, it's very easy to find out the relative density or density index. So ID is equal to E max minus E, E max minus E minimum. So just put the value of E max, E minimum, and natural void ratio. By that, you will get the value of ID, and it's coming as 50%. So it is for particular this problem, the answer will be option C, that is 50%. Okay, so it's a very simple question. Okay, only you need to remember this formula for relative density. Okay, let's say remember, it's best better you understand the concept of relative density. If you can have a good understanding of relative density, okay, then you will not, it is not going to be tough for you to understand this. Okay, E max minus E divided by E max minus E minimum. Okay, and it gives relative density or density index. Okay, so I think it is clear. So let's go back to the next one. So next question is from GATE examination 2005. Okay. So what is this question all about? So the question says that a saturated soil mass has a total density of 22 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay. So density of a particular soil, total density is given as 22 kilonewton per meter cube. And a water content of 10%. So water content or moisture content, whatever you say, is given as 10%. The bulk density and dry density of the soils are. So simply you are asked to find out bulk density and dry density of the soil. Okay. For this question, there is no option. Okay, you just simply need to find out the answer. Okay. So here, total density of the soil, you can give a symbol of gamma T, T for total. Gamma T is given as 22 kilonewton per meter cube, and moisture content is given as 10%. So with these two information, you can directly find out the dry density directly. Okay, so dry density of the soil. Dry density of the soil is given by, you can find out by gamma T. Here it is not W, it is by mistake it's come W, it should be gamma T. Okay, there is this W should not be there. Okay, it should be gamma T, that is the total density or bulk density by 1 plus W. Fine. So it is a formula you have to remember to find out the dry density. And related to bulk density, simply it is that total density. Okay, bulk density. In this particular question, you need to find out bulk density and dry density also. Okay, but you have to know total density itself is bulk density. So whatever the value is given as a total density, it is actually your bulk density. Bulk means total. So simply you can put gamma T equal to 22 kilonewton per meter cube. That represents your bulk density. Fine. It's little bit of a tricky question. And dry density is, how can you find out dry density? Gamma T by 1 plus W. And gamma T, that is bulk density, is given as 22 by 1 plus W. W is given as 10%. Okay, 10% means 0.1. Just simplify, solve this, and you will find 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, so this is the answer for this question. Next, come to this question, and it is also a GATE question, and it is came in the year of 2004. Okay, so this question is also similar to the last question that we already discussed in the previous class. So a certain soil has specific gravity of solid, capital GS. Specific gravity of solid is given as 2.71. okay, it's given as 2.71. And porosity, eta or n, represents your porosity of the soil, and it's given as 40%. And w is what, your moisture content or water content, is given as 10%, sorry, 10 20%. Okay, so with this information, you need to find out the degree of saturation of the soil. Degree of saturation of the soil. So to find out degree of saturation, you know the formula ES equal to WG. ES is equal to WG, where E is your void ratio, S is your degree of saturation, W is your moisture content or water content, and G is your specific gravity of solid. You can put capital G or sometimes capital GS also be used. Okay, so don't confuse. Same thing. Okay. So in this formula, you need to find out S. Moisture content W is given as 20%. Specific gravity is given as 2.71. But E is not known to you now. For this, you will have to find out void ratio also. Now, how can you find out void ratio? Since porosity is given as 40%, and we know the relation between porosity and void ratio. So first, let's find out void ratio by using the value of porosity. Okay, so void ratio is equal to E is equal to N by 1 minus N. You have to remember this formula also. So N, value of N is given as 0.4, or 40% is put 0.4, then 1 minus 0.4, and you will get finally the value of E, void ratio is 2 by 3. Okay, simply put the value of E, W and capital G. It is now very easy to find out degree of saturation. How can you find out? S is equal to, simply put the value of all the value that it is known to you. Okay. S equal to WG by E. Just put the value and you will get the answer. And it's coming as 81.30%. Okay. Is there any doubt till now? Only thing you have to do to understand the relation between the English property. First of all, you have to understand the three-phase diagram. Then you have to understand the different property of the soil, starting from unit weight, dry density, different types of unit weight, different types of dry density, different types of density. Then void ratio, porosity, degree of saturation, moisture content, relative density, air content, okay, percentage air voids. There are lots of parameters, specific gravity. Okay, all these things you have to understand first of all. After that, you have to go by finding the relation between all these parameter, correlation. Okay, like this, ES is equal to WG. It is the correlation between void ratio, degree of saturation, moisture content, and specific gravity. Like that, we have this relation of dry density with bulk density and moisture content. This is a relation between these three parameters. Okay, so like this, there are three or four main correlation that already I have given in the previous class. You just try to understand that formula. You can memorize it. Okay, and it will come from practice. Try to solve more and more numerical, then it will come on easy on me. Fine. Now, is it clear till now? Is there any doubt? You can ask me now. Okay, wait a second, I'm just coming. Okay, till then, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. I'm coming. Okay, just check the numerical. सो नो डाउट, चलो ठीक है. सो विल प्रोसीड टू द लास्ट प्रॉब्लम न्यूमेरिकल दैट आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर यू. ओके, सो दिस इज अ न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम गेट एग्जामिनेशन 2016. ओके, सो इन दिस न्यूमेरिकल लेट्स रीड इट आउट फॉर यू. The porosity and degree of saturation of a soil sample are 0.7 and 40% respectively. Okay, that means for a particular soil, porosity that is small n is given as 0.4. Okay, and degree of saturation is given as 40%. That is capital S is given as 40%. Okay, so in a 100 meter cube volume of soil, that is the total volume of the soil is given as 100 meter cube. The volume of air is, now in this particular problem, you need to find out volume of air in meter cube. So it's look like very little bit confusion, a little bit complex, but it's very simple to find out if you follow a basic simple understanding. Okay, so in this particular numerical we have three parameter that known to you, and what are the parameter is given to you? Porosity, degree of saturation, and total volume. Okay, total volume is given as 100 meter cube. Now by definition of porosity, what is the definition of porosity? Porosity is defined as the ratio of volume of voids by total volume of the soil, isn't it? Volume of voids by total volume. Fine. So simply just put that relation. Okay, that is porosity N is given as volume of voids, that is capital VV, by total volume, that is capital V. And the value is given as 0.4. Simply put this value. And we know the total volume. Isn't it? Total volume is known to you. The value of porosity is known to you. Now you can simply easily find out the volume of voids. This volume of voids can be found out by 0.7 multiply the total volume. That is 100, and it's coming as 70 meter cube. Now if I can draw the T-phase diagram here, oh sorry, if I draw a three-phase diagram here, suppose this is your solid part, this is your water part, and this is your air part. Okay, so total volume is given as how much? 100. Okay, so using this relation, so total volume is given as 100 meter cube. Okay, so using this relation of porosity, or definition of porosity, now we get your volume of void, that is this total volume, this total volume of voids, these things is given as how much you have got? 70, isn't it? Total volume, that is this total volume of voids, it is a summation of what? Volume of air and volume of water, isn't it? Okay, so we can write in terms of VV, total volume of voids, or simply volume of voids can be divided in volume of water and volume of air. So VW plus VA, and it is as V equal to 70. Now, if you can anyhow you can find out volume of W, if you can find out volume of W, this amount. Now, if you can find out the volume of W, it's become very easy to find out volume of air. Now, how can you find out volume of water? For that, you have to use the definition of degree of saturation. Now, degree of saturation is, as per definition of degree of saturation, is what? It is a ratio of volume of water by volume of void, isn't it? Volume of water by volume of void. Now, in this formula, degree of saturation is known to you, that is 40%. Volume of voids, that is already we determined as 70, and only unknown is volume of water. Now simply, you in this formula just put this value of S and VV, so we can find out the volume of water. VW equal to 0.4 into 70, it's coming as 28 meter cube. Now simply in this equation, if you can make one equation like whatever you can say, suppose in equation 1, put the value of VW, okay, and it is now very easy to find out VA, that is volume of air, that is 70 minus 28, it's coming as, how much, it's coming as this 42 meter cube. So, the volume of air in meter cube is coming as 42 meter cube, okay. Clear? So this is all about today class. We have discussed, I think, how much? 4 numerical, right? So I advise you to go through this numerical. Okay, it will help you to understand the numerical based on English properties of soil. Okay, there are many in this kind of numerical in textbooks or reference book, whatever you are following, you go through that. Fine. So with this, I just want to close my sharing here. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me now. And if you don't have any doubt, then I'll do one thing. I'll wait. Let me first take the screenshot of your participation list. Okay, just wait. Okay, is there no any doubt, then you can leave the class. We have already taken the participation list, so don't worry, I'll give the attendance.